Tom, what are you doing here?
Anti-lymphocyte globulin chained with 10% cortical steroids and azathioprine.
What?
Look, we need the azathioprine because it prevents allograft rejection. It kills the healthy immune cells, so we added cortical steroids, which helped, but then the toxicity levels were too high. With ALG, we get the same immunosuppression response with lower doses of azathioprine, lower cortical steroids.
What's that?
This is a patient. I just need you to sign off on it.
Tom, they put a moratorium on liver transplants everywhere. Not just here, everywhere. The whole world has its eyes on the danger of these procedures.
She's going to die. We have the best chance that she's got.
How sure about this, are you?
I am 100%.
It's your reputation, not mine. Tom, if you lose her, I'm not sure I can have you on staff here.
Dr. Starzel.
Nurse, hemostat.
It's coming.
VP is dropping.
Ruby.
Jesus Christ.
Where's the heart rate?
Horn, I'm gonna have to call you back.
Did you wanna see me?
Yeah, can you tell me about this?
She's turning 2, and her parents asked if you could make it.
Dr. Horn. Which outlet is it this time? Hang on a second. It's for you. New England Journal of Medicine. I told you. This is your reputation, not mine.
Dr. Starzel.
Dr. Thomas Tarzal was certainly a pioneer in the field of organ transplantation. Once surgeons remove an organ, it is separated from its blood supply. It no longer gets oxygen or nutrients. Classically, the way that was mitigated was to cool the organ down. That way it would slow the metabolism. We would take them out quickly, put them on ice, and try and get that into someone who needs a transplanted organ within 4 to 6 hours. When we look at the number of organs that are donated nationwide, there is a high wastage. A lot of those organs cannot be used. In our laboratory back in the 1990s, we were looking at the viability of cold storage. We thought we could come up with a more physiologic way of preserving organs, that would be a better solution. Warm perfusion is a way of maintaining a donated organ in a more natural state by using blood to perfuse an organ to keep it beating. Using warm perfusion, we were able to keep it alive for 12 hours. The intracellular pH was just as good as if the organ was never taken out of the body. The percentage of organs that can be used far surpasses that of cold storage. This is a way to keep donated organs going for a long time. It made me feel proud that we had had an innovation that was recognized by the U.S. Patent Office. I've always been driven by the mission of taking care of veterans to make sure that their care was as good or better than any place in America.
I served in the United States Army for 8 years. When I initially came to the VA as an employee, they give you a complete physical. And I remember the human resource specialist calling me and saying, hey, you know, we want to hire you, but we need you to see a nephrologist. Do you know that you're in kidney failure? And I remember saying, excuse me? They connected me to the nephrologist at the VA. I said to him, if I don't want dialysis, what is that going to look like? He said, well, I'm going to be honest. If you don't, then you would expire. And at that moment, I knew it was getting real. I went on a kidney transplant list. It was about 13 months. I was retaining a lot of fluids and was getting rather weak. The day I got the phone call from the VA, they said, hey, we got a kidney for you, but it's been outside of the body now for about 12, 14 hours. There's a 75% chance that it will not wake up inside your body. And I'm like, call my surgeon, let's do it. I remember waking up in my room and I looked down and I saw the staples and I knew that that organ was inside of me and it was working. My daughter was there. She said, Mom, you look so much brighter. And I felt it. I felt another life inside of me. And I remember the tears rolling down my face. I wake up every day with gratitude for him. He was a 22-year-old, young, hopeful college student who had a fatal accident. And his mother wrote me a beautiful letter. And his mother said her only solace in life is knowing that her son's kidney is keeping someone else alive. So I feel like I'm not doing it just for me, but I'm doing it for them.
Dr. Starzel's contributions to medicine in general, and certainly the field of transplantation using cold storage, the old-fashioned way, were huge. But this is a different paradigm. Warm perfusion is expanding the pool of donors. I still keep in contact with some of the patients that I've operated on. Doctor-patient relationship is what drives every physician. It is that interaction that you cherish every day.
I can honestly say the care I received, the VA, they loved me well.
To fix that problem and have the patient come back and is better is a joy that really cannot be matched.